Hi everybody, we're gonna start on the floor and try to do some om chanting just to get the breath control. So chanting is like doing the breathing. Pranayama is the same things because you're controlling your breath as you make the sound om. I'm going to sit cross-legged and on my cushions, and I'm not forcing too much in my knees. I want to be comfortable, so I found the relaxed sukhasana. Gonna get some oils going so that I can relax and take my intention and attention into my practice today. So when we prepare, clear our space, then opening space around, and then we open the space in the mind too. So you're not stuck in one little opinion or thought. So you can change your thoughts throughout the day and make them more positive. All one we want to do is see things as they are and not create stories. They are not belong to our reality. So I'm just gonna place the smell. I got this lemongrass and ginger, I think. I'm feeling a little under weather, so this is going to feel a little bit more energizing for me today. And my voice is a bit croaky, so maybe this is gonna help me. So I'm using oil that is gonna be helpful for me. So you might need a different oil, so you can just choose your own aromatherapy oils and just try to get into the mood for the session. And there, I'm gonna stop and relax. If you rub your third eye here with your finger, focus on it, even though your eyes are open, you're focusing on the third eye. So that means your eyes are focusing in the middle. You don't try to close your eyes, you just want to look. You can look at a flower, or if you have views of the outside, green trees, or image of trees on your desk somewhere. Just focus. Try to keep the eyes focused and see how long you can do this before you blink. And if you try to not blink, you're gonna blink a lot to stop it. This is normal. Taking deep breaths to keep the focus. Try to relax the mind. As the eyes stop wandering, notice how your mind settles, your body settles, your breathing gets naturally deep because you're trying to focus the eyes. Chant om on the next exhalation. Take a deep breath in. Start in the belly. One more time. Oh. notice the vibrations you create in your chest, your belly, your ribs, even your throat when you do the sound in the end. So you can see all the sound that you create has resonation in a different part of the breath and power your body. So you need to keep your body nice and open. Let's try again. So just now I'm gonna go out. So you're gonna go out. Ad, then gura, 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 name, name. So you're seeing, you're using your vibration in the mouth and the tongue. So we put them together. Ad, gure, name. Ad, gure, name. Ad gure name, ad gure name. Then we're gonna do jugad gure name, jugad, 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 jugad gure name, jugad gure name. Put them together. Ad gure name, jugad gure name. Then comes sat, sat gure name, sat gure name, sat gure name. So we're gonna put the three together. Ad gure name, jugad gure name, sad gure name, siri guru dewe name, siri guru dewe name, siri guru dewe name, siri guru dewe name. Now we're gonna put them together. Ad gure name, jugad gure name, sad gure name, siri guru deve name. So I did it all in one breath because it's going to be hard for you to do it all in one breath. So we're gonna cut it in half. So we do the first two sentences. Ad gure name, jugad gure name in one breath. Sat gure name, siri guru deve name in the other breath. So let's go. Inhale. Ad gure name, jugad gure name. Sat gure name, siri guru deve name. Relax. It's hard to get the words out, let alone do it to the breath that I'm asking you to do. So we are going to try our best. So you can do two breaths or just in one breath. Let's see how it goes. Ad gure name, jugad gure name, sad gure name, siri guru deve name. Ad gure name, jugad gure name, sad gure name, siri guru deve name. Ad gure name, jugad gure name, sad gure name, siri guru deve name. Try to slow it. Ad gure name, jugad gure name, sad gure name, siri guru deve name. Ad gure name, jugad gure name, sad gure name, siri guru deve name. You'll find in time you'll get your own melody going, and then you might have to stop and start but to take breath. It's okay. Ad gure name, jugad gure name, sad gure name, siri guru deve name. Ad gure name, jugad gurey name, sat gurey name, sri guru devay name. Ad gurey name, jugad gurey name, sat gurey name, sri guru devay name. Ad gurey name, jugad gurey name, sat gurey name, sri guru devay name. Ad gurey name, jugad gurey name, sat gurey name, sri guru devay name. Ad gurey name, jugad gurey name, sat gurey name, sri guru devay name. One last time. Ad gurey name, jugad gurey name, sat gurey name, sri guru devay name. Now close your eyes. Relax, relax your cheeks, your jaw. Relax your shoulders, your wrists, your elbows. Feel the crown of the head elevate. Feel your seat bones sink to the ground. Take deep sighing breaths. Notice the vibrations you created in your body. Just try to relax into your bones. All the muscles feeling fluffy. Focusing on the third eye. When the eyes are closed, you can really focus on the middle of the eyebrow. And you'll see a light. Focus on that light. Check your breath so it's there. We chant it for universal peace, connection, protection. We want to be connected. Connect with your seat bones and the sacrum to the ground. We want to be nourished. Feeling the sun in your skin. We want to be calm, elevating the spine towards the sky to keep it cool and wise. Keep the breath deep, intention soft, your spine upright. Soften your fingers, soften your wrists. Soften your elbows, soften your shoulders. Soften the neck muscles. Notice how your mood changes and gets lighter when oxygen is every part of you. When we were chanting, we were extending our breath. That was getting you more connected with the whole of the cells, creating vibrations, getting the mind-body connection. Now we can open our eyes. We want to open the chakras a little bit more now, so I'm just gonna move to the side and the other side. So you can just lift one knee and lift the other knee. So you want to feel the seat bones. Lift, lift, one side, other side. You can use your arms to help you. I got nice soft cushions here, so they're kind of supporting me. And relax a little bit more with the neck also. Just feel like somebody's pushing you one side and pushing you the other side. Don't go fast. You might get sick. Now next time we're going to go forwards and then back. I need to take the cushion out, otherwise it makes me feel full. I'll go forwards and then around. And forwards and then around. I'm finding comfort. You can stay on the cushion and not push too far forwards. Don't topple. So I feel my hips, my lower back, my knees, and they're all being challenged. I got pins and needles now on my legs because I've been sitting on this position for a long time. So you can change the front leg to make it move other way around. Next, changing circles. Breathe in, breathe out. I want you to feel the tension. Where do you feel it most? Is it your knees? Is it your back? Is it your hips? So there's always some kind of connection. My back feels really tight at the moment. So I'm feeling it in my lower back. One more time. And then we can just relax and sit. Now just try to feel the seat bones a little bit more. I warmed up the hip area. I'm noticing there's some tension there I need to work on through the lower back into my hips here. Now I'm just gonna go knees in, knees out. So I'm moving up, moving down, moving up, moving down, not forcing my knees, but noticing how when I extend here, I feel the seat bones separate and my hips go a bit more stretch. Now we're gonna change the front leg and do the same thing on the other side. This side feels a bit more open for me. It's really uneven on each side. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. And exhale. Inhale. And exhale one more time. Then I'm going to kind of get onto my feet here. Try to lift my bum up and my bum down. Bum up and down. Using my legs and my arms to come up and down. Change front leg again. One more. And then relax down. I know the arms pushed hard, but I'm just still trying to work my core and my pelvic floor here. And I'm going to sit comfortably, noticing the pins and needles in the hip area. Try to relax this area now. Just relax your hips. Relax your stomach muscles. Breathe. And know that you're breathing, relaxing the shoulders, your cheeks and your jaw. Notice the tension you're carrying in your abs. Just soften them a bit more. You want to melt into the ground. Feel the hip bones relax. We keep a lot of emotional tension in the pelvis area. We got two chakras sit in front of each other. So that it's down in the two ways and Mulan, that one chakra is on the back. So they really do our control in the back and front ways. So we just want to soften this area because we have to hold on to it so much. So it can make blockages. So you want to soften the seat bones, soften your pelvic floor. And then have some kindness towards your pelvis. You don't want to be judgmental towards yourself. So if this is the moment, you can just let go, relax, appreciate what your body has to do to keep you functioning, keep you moving on. So you can detox the body whenever you need to go to the loo, you're not holding on. Feel the release. Sometimes emotional stress can cause indigestion and problems in the bowels. Soften the bowels. So you can let go. Breathing deeply also helps to massage the abs here. But even when we are breathing, you're holding too much tension. So we say to pump the stomach, so we want to be more soft. And let's go on to the chest area. So we've got the middle of the body, which is the solar plexus, and then we can really feel the burn through here. But I'm going to skip that area and go towards the chest straight away with the Anahata chakra. So you can just circle the spine and the shoulders and just go one side. Breathe in, breathe out. This is another mobile area, so we can be doing lots with the arms and the shoulders through this area. I mean, it gets tight, so let's try to open this area up. So we were talking about emotional blockages. Sometimes it happens in here too, because you get hurt and you stop loving or giving, and you become all stale in the heart. So we're gonna go inhale, exhale, inhale, and exhale. Inhale. Now we are really going into the solar plexus as well, as you pull the belly in here. Crown of the head up. Now notice all the hardship you felt through the chest and the belly, and try to relax and soften this area. You want to feel light and happiness in the heart, lungs. Relax the shoulders. Each breath is bringing joy and happiness into your body, into your mind. Each exhalation, you're getting rid of all the worries, insecurities, and stress. And exhale. Just every exhalation, feel the arms loosen up even more. The tension through the arms is like anger. If you soften the intention, arms become more soft and gentle. In return, you get relaxation in the neck and the chest. So let the burden of the arms wash away from your chest. Shine the chest up and forwards, keeping your hips soft, your middle burning, your heart open. So we got four chakras all working together now. So it is done. Malandra, Manipura, Anahata, they're all in the torso. Let me try to awaken the Kundalini here. Just feel the connection between the sacrum into the chest and the heart. Feel the breath rise up and elevate you. As you're exhaling, you're not collapsing under pressure, you're staying upright. Soften the arms, soften the knees, soften your hips, but manage to connect with the spine. Now we're gonna start rotating. So get one arm over the other, inhale, exhale. This is another way to open all the sides of the body. I'm gonna close my eyes. Feel the spine elevate and rise and freeze up. And change the arm on top. Inhale to the other side, exhale to the other side. feeling more oxygenated in the spine, and all your chakras started to connect. You're moving up to the throat here, Vishuddha chakra. As you exhale, try to narrow the throat to get those vibrations. When we were chanting, we were already resonating in our throat, so your Vishuddha chakra, your expression was becoming more and more unblocked. So notice the sacrum all the way up to the chest, throat, and all the way to third eye. Touch your third eye with your finger. Feel the Kundalini breakthrough rising up in the middle. Feel all the channels connecting, your energy rising, your mind is free. You don't want any blockages in any part. If you have any issues that are rising up now, you're resisting the freedom, just work through it. Try to pierce through all the negativity. Soften the muscles of the lower abs, your pelvic floor. Feel the heart open, chest open, throat open. Each breath is elevating inside of you. You're raising with energy. Start trusting yourself. Do not let yesterday's pain continue today. Look for answers, it's inside of you. You are healthy, happy. You want to heal. You want to live freely. Do not let prejudice make you closed. Do not let heartbreak make you closed. Just open your heart. There's so many different ways to love, express. Just find a way that you can do and do well. Forget about your failures. Think about what might be today, tomorrow. You have all the reasons to be in this earth. Make your life worth a lot. It's not about the money. It's about what you do, how you connect, how you touch others. Shine and do your best. You are not what you're conditioned to be. You can be anything you want. Feel the breath rise from sacrum to the crown. Exhale. Keep the spine nice and tall and open. And again. Now we chant Om. Shanti, shanti. Let the sound penetrate. Then float your arms, join your palms above the head. As you pass the face, touch your third eye with your thumbs, your face, your chin. Bring the hands to the chest, open your eyes. Give me a bow of appreciation here. Namaste, everybody. I hope that's kind of helped. Notice how much more oxygen you can take and how it can make you so much more positive. I hope that continues all throughout the day today. See you later. Bye.